inside the campaign?
None. That is completely invented.
Yet somehow, not by accident, it became a Fox and Friends talking point that a presidential tweet that something the White House believes should be looked into. Which you will remember is how the Devin Nunes shenanigans played out last year. The House Intelligence Chairman rushed to the White House to brief the president on shocking information he had just learned about. Shocking information he had just learned from inside the White House itself. That is the cycle this seems to be following. Yet as it plays out, Robert Mueller is going about his work. And according to Michael Caputo, who appears frequently on this program and was interviewed by the Mueller team, the focus is squarely on the one thing the president has most adamantly denied, collusion. And just yesterday, we learned what Donald Trump Jr. told the Senate panel about his meeting with Russians offering, let's just speak plainly here, to collude with the Trump campaign. The Russians were promising dirt. Donald Trump Jr. wanted it, and after the meeting was over, what he was most disappointed about was that they didn't offer more. So his father apparently sees collusion the way a vampire sees garlic. His son seems to view it as catnip to a tabby, and the president's new lawyer says, even if it did happen, so what?
That's what you do. Except maybe you shouldn't, but you do it. Nothing illegal about that. And even if it comes from a Russian or a German or an American, doesn't matter.
Rudy Giuliani made more news late today. He told the PBS NewsHour that the special counsel's team communicated last night with the president's lawyers, and he says they're narrowing down questions for him. Whether that means the president will actually agree to be questioned, he only said it looks more hopeful than it did a day or so ago. Our Gloria Borger has much more on that shortly. First, though, her report, our best inside look at the investigation itself.
Experiencing Team Mueller up close is no walk in the park.
It's intense, you know. First of all, they ask to pick you up at a nearby hotel because they want to sneak you in a back door. And that's the way they want to drop you off as well if you're done. It's also not a friendly environment. They're professional. I wouldn't call it polite.
But they are well informed.
They know more about the Trump campaign than any single person who's worked there. That's because they have everybody's documents. The Mueller investigation knows people more than any one person does. And anybody who sits with them, you can buy into it.
Especially the president, as both he and his revolving team of lawyers are well aware.
What would Trump risk if he were to testify?